Masterminds. So this is this Friday morning, the 5th of Kali, the 5th of August already, the Courage Hour. So we have a couple minutes to mastermind around anything. I think I shared a week or so ago, maybe more, that I had taken the courage to go ahead and put in my intent to run for city council again. And so I'm mustering up the courage to get my petition signed. I'm going to work on that today, later this evening. I have to get 20 signatures of people in my district. I just haven't done it, you know, so obviously there's some reason I haven't done it. So I'm going to get the, just go ahead and do it. And that whole thing takes courage. So I'm working on that.
So cool. Well, I think courage right now is, for me, is continuing to listen to feedback and listen to what stirs within me from what I hear. That's really taking courage for me, and being in the silence of hearing the feedback and then sitting with, you know, what makes sense, what moves me to move forward.
Yeah. I want to acknowledge you for that. That's great awareness. And certainly a compassionate way to move forward, you know, to accept and listen to, and then internalize and take action on that. Yeah, I acknowledge you for that. That's awesome. And you're moving in so many ways, young lady, taking on managing director, full capacity, and on OP, and just so many things. I mean, you are in my thoughts and heart every day. So
thank you.
So let's go forth. We shall work on our intention. I'll see you back. I'm going to pause the recording because. We were talking about listening, which then prompted me to think about listening to, you know, listening to yesterday. I didn't have a lot to do and I got a lot done, if that makes sense. My calendar was pretty open. And so I just listened to my, I don't know whether it's your soul, your heart, your head, whatever. I listened to myself about that, and kind of ruminated on that all day yesterday. And it led me to do some things that I normally would have just pushed aside. So I thought, there's something here. Something to think about, really. So this morning in my intention, in my journal, I wrote, today I'm going to practice being with myself, for myself, and be attentive to what comes to me, you know. So that was, and that came from you talking about the courage to listen. So I appreciate that.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, so let's talk a little bit about the courage to listen. Why does that take courage? You know, what's behind that? What's the why of that?
Yeah, I think so. Something that came through in the Manifesting a Fearless Life audio that I was just tuning into in our time away. One of the things that I wrote down that really resonated with me is that my thoughts are a call from the universe to heal with courage.
Mm.
And what you were just saying just made me think of how, you know, why does it take courage to listen? And I think that has to do with, you know, when we hear things, especially if it's to heal something or to, you know, decide something, the thoughts that come through in whatever we're hearing, it takes courage to actually listen to our own thoughts, that voice inside, and our own intuition. Because I think we don't tend to give ourselves, as humans, we don't tend to give ourselves enough space to be silent, be still. And you sharing about, you know, your calendar was pretty open yesterday, and yet you feel, what I hear is, you know, fulfillment. Mm-hmm. You know, like there was great things that happened in that. When you look at it on paper, it's open, and yet you gave yourself the space to intuitively listen to what you wanted to move toward and take action on or sit with longer. And I think as humans, we can all practice that more.
Yeah, I wrote that down. My thoughts from the universe are a call to take courage, or a call for courage. I wrote both down.
Yeah. Heal with courage.
Yeah. Heal with courage. Mm-hmm. Is that what you said? Okay.
Yeah. Thoughts are a call from the universe to heal with courage.
Okay. I'm going to add that.
Yeah.
So I've got three things that they are. I always, and I'm starting to think this is maybe not the truth for me as well. I always, you know, I think saying we're in our head or our heart is just way too simple. There's so much more to it than one or the other, or even integration of the two. It's a deeper process than that. And I always say things like, oh, I'm always in my head and I need to get in my heart. And it just, that no longer feels trite or too simple for me now. So what does that mean to me? You know, and I think this is really part of it, is that being in my head is okay. Those are my thoughts. Being in my heart's my feelings. That's great too. And integrating those is a possibility, but maybe just sitting with the thoughts by themselves and accepting what they are, sitting with the feelings and letting those go through me, knowing I'm not my feelings, and just really understanding how that whole process works. Because that book that we're reading, that Happy Pocket Full of Money, which just hasn't even thought about money during the whole book yet, but I mean, I'm only on the third chapter, has really got me thinking again about our creation, about you know, the nature of God and how he is everywhere, but yet he is still, you know, just whatever your beliefs are about the nature of God, and that we are all the same. We're all created exactly the same in terms of the level, the condition, the amount of energy that we have, and then it's what we do with it, right? And that's why we come to the earth, is to grow that energy and become that person that we were created to be, which is unique. And so I all that's just kind of, you know, going around in my thoughts. And like you said, just listening to that. I haven't gotten on Fearless You since I took myself off the faculty. If you remember that whole decision I had to make, yeah. You know, you were with me on that. I have not returned at all to Fearless You. Not as a rebellion or anything, just as I eliminated that off my plate. And so I eliminated it off my plate. I was drawn to go last night. My calendar was empty enough that I could go. And here it was on my essential nature, you know, is compassion. And so I was able to contribute to the chat and the discussion in a way that I felt like, yes, I am becoming the essence of compassion, which was the thing I denied myself the most in my life. And that was very validating. So again, I had that thought, that feeling, I was drawn there. So more of my ability to do that might depend on giving myself more space And then listening both to my thoughts and my feelings, not saying they have to be together, they have to anything. It's just, that's what they are. I don't know. That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah, that's beautiful. I love that. I love that. Sometimes that's what we need, is just, you know, the freedom space. And that's kind of been the conversation this morning that we've been having, is really like being on vacation every day and like looking at life as an adventure, mm-hmm. right? Every day versus an escape.
Right.
So yeah, I think those are really important pieces of being able to, you know, make moves toward what we want and be still when we need to be, so that the right next move can come to us. Yeah. You know, we can feel it.
Yeah. Well, the exercise she gave everybody to do last night, and I could have thought, oh, I'm already there. You know, I'm practicing compassion, thinking I'm doing it all the time, which, you know, I know nothing is the definite, was to cut a bunch of hearts or something like that. Mm-hmm. And so I did. While I was sitting there, I cut myself a little plate of hearts. And then when you are aware that you're not giving yourself compassion, you're beating yourself up, you're having expectations, you're complaining, whatever it is, grab one of those little hearts and I'm going to tape it on my door and just see how far I could still, how much more I could give myself compassion. I thought, you know, some people won't even do that because they beat themselves up. They won't do it because they have no compassion for themselves, right? They'll say, I'm not going to do that. They'll negate that evidence. And I thought, heck, I'm going to do that, because I'm sure there are times I'm still beating myself up, or I'm feeling lonely because I'm beating myself up. And it doesn't seem like I'm beating myself up, but underneath that it is. Or I'm going to the past and letting it, you know, bring my feelings up and forgetting that I'm loved just the way I am. So anyway, that was the exercise, and I'm going to do that because I think that will help me go deeper with more rigor in looking at, have I embodied compassion? Yeah, a lot more than I did in the past. Can I embody it more for myself? Yes.
That's awesome. I'm looking forward to hearing and seeing the heart as it comes to keep building on your awareness and having the courage to do that and to have that awareness.
Yeah. Well, we're past the hour. I always love talking to you.